Hello, I'm Ingo Brissner. I'm a software developer and data scientist at BAM, and today I want to give a short introduction to SASfit. It's a program for analyzing complex small-angle scattering data. It exists since several tens of years already, and it contains many models, simple ones but also advanced ones. I will give a short overview of small-angle scattering pattern analyzers. Then I explain in short SASfit and the modeling concept and some features of it which might be useful, especially the multi-fit, which is also called global fitting, for more advanced measurements, series measurements, and so on. There are different ways to look at the two-dimensional pattern which is measured on small-angle scattering instruments. The most common approach here is one-dimensional fitting. To get a one-dimensional curve from a two-dimensional image, we can do radial averaging, for example, which is shown here on the left side. This produces a one-dimensional curve, as shown here on the right side, of a spherical scatterer, for example. But with two-dimensional images, there are more options what to do with the measurement. So, for example, you could also pick sections through the two-dimensional image, as shown here on the left side. This would also result in a one-dimensional curve average, but only averaged over a part of the image. This results in four one-dimensional scattering curves at a certain angle psi, also for a spherical scatterer. This exact 2D scattering image is from the SASfit manual for a orientational distribution. So in this case, the one-dimensional curve is taken radially through the two-dimensional scattering image, as indicated by the curved arrow on the left side. It fits a curve which goes around the image along the circle, over the angle theta. So this would also be possible with SASfit. So, why SASfit? First of all, it offers many advanced features which are often not so strong advertised, because it's developed step-by-step by the original author, Joachim Kohlbrecher. He also added many more tools and features during his work, and we continue development and support. One option is model-free analyzers. It starts with analyzing a curve in the Gounier region, does some Gounier fitting, and also a Perot fitting is available in the Perot region of a scattering curve. But also for a longer time now is the Ornstein-Czernicke solver included. It allows you to set up your own structure factors, like defining a potential and calculating a numerical structure factor from that. You can then use this numerical structure factor in your fitting routine. But it also offers expectation maximization and some regularization methods. All this is work in progress, but can also already be used in some of the development versions, and a new version is coming up soon, which contains this on a regular basis. In general, SASfit is a curve-fitting toolbox, which is a very generic working principle. It provides building blocks for setting up custom so-called supermodels. This is similar to other small-angle scattering analysis programs. There's a measured intensity, which is highlighted here in green, and basically this is broken down into different parts. So it consists often of an integral for the polydispersity, as shown here in parentheses, and a form factor, which is indicated by a capital P here. The size distribution or parameter distribution is the lower F, highlighted in orange. The structure factor indicated with a capital S and in blue. And in this way, incorporating a structure factor is called a monodisperse approximation. That's the simplest way. But there are also more methods to incorporate structure factors, such as the local monodisperse approximation. And there are even three more ways to calculate the intensity with a structure factor attached. Let me give a short overview of the general modeling concept. Here you see a window of the SASfit program where you can configure your model setup. It's a simple case for only a single model to fit to a scattering curve. So in this area you set your parameters, and when you press simulate, for example, the calculated model intensity is shown in a different window or can be fitted to the loaded data, as shown here on the right. Here again, we have the building blocks of the scattering formula. So the form factors highlighted in red corresponds to the right side of this parameter window. And there's a size distribution here highlighted in orange, which is on the left side of the parameter window. And on another tab, you can add and configure a structure factor. You can select the actual pre-configured model of the structure factor, here under number 2 highlighted. There are many more models for structure factors available. And the program in general has a rather steep learning curve, but it's also very flexible and has many advanced analysis methods implemented and can come in handy at some point. In the next step, you configure the actual values for the structure factor in the lower part. On the right side, you select the way how to incorporate the structure factor. Here is the previously described monodisperse approximation selected under the point 4. And also the local monodisperse approximation can be recommended from time to time when it's important to couple the repulsion radius of the structure factor to the actual scatterer size. This can be quite useful, but be warned, it also comes with a price in calculation time. And along with each type of structure factor incorporation, there's a rough formula as some kind of help to denote in which way the form factor and the structure factor are incorporated, because not for every form factor, every way of incorporating a structure factor is possible, because for some method it needs form factor which is defined in a different way. For example, the decoupling approach next to the squared and averaged form factor amplitude, it requires also the non-squared averaged form factor, which is not always implemented for every model. So then the formulas you see, there's a form factor squared and averaged, and also a form factor averaged and then squared. This non-squared form factor needs to be implemented in each model, and if it's not available, you will typically get an error message. Just to let you know, there are some requirements connected with each method of structure factor incorporation. So from here, when the structure factor is configured, I can easily plot the structure factor alone to have a quick overview of what the structure factor would look like. There's a button in the lower part. There you can switch between plotting the structure factor alone or the actual intensity curve. Another important point here is the upper bar of the configuration window, where you can select the contributions. This is where you can stack together your models and add multiple scattering models together, because every contribution is just added to the contribution before, and the sum of all the contributions make up your intensity pattern, which is then compared to the measured intensity. So here I tried to visualize this. First, I configured a sphere with 20 nanometer radius with some size distribution or polydispersity applied. And then I would add another contribution of a sphere, which is just slightly bigger, for example, 40 nanometers, and also with the polydispersity applied. And the result of the intensity will then be the sum of the two intensities of the two models I configured. And going one step further, there's even a bit more complex configuration window for so-called global fitting, which provides not only contributions, but also data sets which can be assigned to contributions. This is highlighted here in red. So you can assign to each contribution a certain data set for which it applies. This enables you to do some global fitting across multiple data sets, multiple measurements, as shown in the plot window in the background, with the different colored curves, which means you can load different measurements and, for example, different environmental settings or environments, and fit all of them to a single model you can configure here. This option for global fitting also provides some kind of global parameters within the model setups. In this way, you can share variables between different models. For example, they can share the same contrast value, or you can even fit a certain shared parameter which exists in multiple models. As you can see, this can get really complex quickly, but this is also some kind of versatility the SASfit program provides. Besides having a steep learning curve, it provides a lot of flexibility towards the end, and especially towards more advanced analyses and configurations. Basically, that's the short overview I wanted to give. You can find SASfit at its webpage under sasfit.org. I would strongly recommend this starting point if you want to know more. And now we will have a quick look at this website. It welcomes you with a short description of the program, and it provides you with more information on the program. Here's a documentation online, which can be viewed directly by clicking on this. It links you to the manual, which is stored on GitHub. It contains lots of scientific documentation of most of the models and implementations, also for the structure factors, for example. So let it load first. It's quite large. This is the form factors. Here's some overview of the regularization process and the Ornstein-Zernike solver and its equations. Many of the definitions and scientific backgrounds for that. Here we have size distributions and peak functions, if you're looking for that. And also the definitions of form factors. Many of the functions were moved to plugin functions recently, so here's a separate section for that. In the form of plugin functions, they can be reused easily in your own plugins for the program, if you want to implement your own models, for example, and reuse a specific already implemented model function. That would be possible. Perhaps one second, I had this open already. Here it shows in the documentation of the model, there are also some three-dimensional plots of the scatterers the models describe. So it can be really complex shapes and types of some very specific form factors. Yeah, I just wanted to mention this. This is some of the more recent implementations here. So the last current version of the program can also be found, of course, on its webpage, sasfit.org, I showed earlier. And here we can visit the GitHub project page. It's basically the page hosting the full source code of the program. And there are also some links again to the automatically built development versions, which get built with every single change of the source code. So at the moment, the latest stable release is a bit old by now, but there are more recent development builds. We are working on a newer release along with a new publication. In the meantime, there are development versions I would refer you to. You can get them here. The upper blue button is the Cloudsmith button, where you can get the latest version of the build. So there are three versions, one for Windows, for macOS, and for Linux. The latest build of the development versions are uploaded here. This means that sometimes they might have issues or still some problems, but in this case, just pick an older version. It's just because these builds are done automatically when something in the source code is changed. If you want to be safe, just pick the latest stable release here on the main page. If you click on release, you get to the release pages. There's also often a quick overview of the changes in the program since the last version and a quick overview along with links to the program version for the different platforms. The changes are basically very often motivated by the work of Joachim in his daily work for his users at his neutron scattering beamline, and sometimes reflects what he is working on with his users. If you have some issues with the program or want to know more, don't hesitate to contact me, ingobressler@bam.de, as shown here in the bottom. And of course, you can also reach out to Joachim. He's also often very responsive to your questions and scientific questions about the models, for example. That's all I wanted to show for a quick introduction to the SASfit program. Thank you for your attention and have fun with model fitting.